Nutrition and Wellness on BCTV is underwritten by Kulp Chiropractic Nutrition and Wellness Center.
Good afternoon, everybody. I am Dr. Kulp from Kulp Chiropractic Nutrition and Wellness Center, and I'm here today to just talk to you about issues about health and nutrition and wellness. So today we're going to talk about an issue that's really dear to me, and that's women's health issues. So we want to just remind women that we really need to remember to put ourselves first when caring for ourselves. Today's show, we're going to talk specifically about women and how we can care for ourselves. And I remind myself, as well as all you listeners out there, that health is a choice. We have to choose health, or we always know the alternative. Yes, it is a choice. We choose health or we choose sickness. We choose how we're going to live. What are we going to do, and how are we going to have those outcomes? There are those unforeseen times when people will get sick and we don't know why and they did all the right things. But most of us have some things in our life that we could severely improve or change. I understand that there's serious diseases out there and we don't have any control over those, but as many as half of the Americans living today suffer from one or more chronic illnesses such as cardiac disease, strokes, cancers, diabetes, obesity, things that we really do truly have control over, and that is by our diet and our lifestyle. I practice functional medicine, and one of the things about functional medicine is it's a way that we can assist our bodies in regenerating itself and healing itself through diet, nutrition, and wellness care. One of my life goals is to teach everyone who listen to me about nutrition and wellness and offer that gift to you. So it's a great time to learn a little bit about optimizing your health and getting where we want to go. And as everybody, I like to remind us the airline stewardess says in the air flight when you're flying. If you don't put the oxygen on yourself first, you can't help the person sitting next to you. So you need to be the ideal example of wellness before you can help your family and give direction and ideas to others. So do like the flight attendant says, put the oxygen on yourself first and see where that may go. And it could change your life and your family's life. And as women, we have that great opportunity to influence many lives, especially our children's life, with what we're doing with our health and our nutrition in our life. Many people ask me questions about things such as, how did I get into the profession? What is the profession? What is functional medicine? So I thought I'd give a little background about functional medicine. I have been practicing for 27 years as a licensed chiropractor, and I have been also practicing I have a diplomat degree in nutrition, which is postgraduate degree, board certified clinical nutritionist. But I've also started another trek, which is working with functional medicine, and it is a holistic natural systems approach. And what we do in this approach is we focus on the physiology, the nutrition, and the genetic factors, and how this may affect your health and the disease process. It's done by evaluating your health needs using whole foods, fresh produce, quality proteins, along with nutritional supplements in order to aid the body in healing itself. The physical components that we do in our office is a consultation, a history, an examination, specialized testing, clinical testing to come up with those results. The bottom line is to keep your health at its optimal level. It's become the goal for many women today. We look at having longer careers, having babies later in life. Today, women are now seeking information for health for many different people, including themselves and their children. And no longer is health just allocated to your medical doctor and you go in and ask for a diagnosis. We are now taking responsibility for our health, and we want to be proactive. So today's show is going to give a lot of information on that. Many health partners help women, fitness instructors, yoga instructors, massage therapists, functional medicine practitioners, chiropractors. There's many people today involved in your health care. So the more information put out there, the more you have to look at and the more you have to decide. But I want to remind people that getting your information from the big box store, from the vitamin store, from magazines and things like this may not be the best place because it's not personalized. So just remember, don't let that fly out the window. We all want to think we know what's best for us, but sometimes testing is the best way. Heart health issues are a big issue today because we have higher death rates than ever before. And women, we have really different issues when we have heart problems. A recent report put out by the National Institute of Health says that women are less likely to receive preventative treatment or guidelines on their lipid-lowering therapies or aspirin therapies or alternative lifestyle changes. There are many factors that can affect our health of our heart. So number one, we look at genetics. Number two is something we can all change, that's lifestyle. Number three is something we can all change, that is nutrition. And number four is stress. So we can't do much about the genes we're born with, but we can do a whole lot about the things like lifestyle, nutrition, and stress. And some of it is just monitoring those factors. Back in 1948, a cardiovascular study was done that was known as the Farmington Study, and this is published many times and it's brought into many debates and other places, but it was designed to, they found a difference in this study that between the men and women and heart issues. Women had a greater risk of heart disease with associated with obesity. We were 64% more likely than men, had a 46% rate of heart disease associated with obesity. So it's very critical for women to maintain our weight. On the downside, as we go through the life changes and menopause and other things, weight gain is an issue. So it's early intervention is the key. Knowing that these things affect us as women, we need to be aware of that. We know men get chest pain typically when they're having a heart attack, but women often get pain in their neck. They'll get jaw pain. They'll have shoulder pain or arm pain. And so oftentimes they'll be able to blow it off to something else and they'll be right in the midst of a heart attack. Many women experience nausea or symptoms of indigestion while beginning with a heart attack. So we don't even present the same way as a man does when having a heart attack. It's been found that women make less CoQ10 than men make. And this is vitally important for the function of the mitochondria, the powerhouse of our cells. So we automatically just don't make the same amount of CoQ10 as men do. So it would be an important supplement to consider taking to be sure that you have enough CoQ10 so your cells have enough power to function and we can stay healthier. CoQ10 is a nutrient needed to help maintain the health of blood vessels. And it reduces the risk of atherosclerosis, which is the plaquing that happens in the arteries. And when we have this such plaquing, this sets us up for blockages and cardiac issues and strokes and vascular diseases. So CoQ10 helps support the action of our heart. It also helps women lower their blood pressure. And I say today's show is really, really focused on ladies. So what you hear today is mostly all about women's health issues. There's a product out there called ubiquinol, which is the active antioxidant state of CoQ10. It is more easily absorbed and bioavailable. Ubiquinol is the fat-soluble molecule, and it's hard to break down in the intestine, so it's better and it can be better absorbed as CoQ10. So if you're looking at ubiquinol, CoQ10, go for the CoQ10. Vitamin and a dosage on that, you know, we're not making a national standard here, but on average, people take somewhere between 100 and 200 milligrams, but you should always be directed on how much to take per your condition. Vitamin E is another healthy supplement for the heart. When we discuss vitamin E, we think about its antioxidant properties, and we all know it's good anti-aging and good for skin and lots of other health issues. Tocopherols and tocarines, to, They're both very similar. They're different components of the vitamin E, and the difference is the tocotrienes is responsible for lowering the cholesterol. So if you're not buying the right vitamin E and you think you're lowering your cholesterol, you may be buying the wrong part of the vitamin E and not being able to do that. It also reduces inflammation, and it leads to a decrease in the C-reactive protein. C-reactive protein is something that we can monitor for chronic inflammation. So when we see elevated C-reactive protein in blood tests that I offer in my office, what we're looking for is, does this patient have an inflammatory reaction? And often they do, and then we can work on lowering that C-reactive protein. And if they're inflamed and we're seeing it in high C-reactive protein, they've got lots of inflammatory things going on in their system, maybe in their joints, maybe in their vessels, maybe in their tissues. So we can manage that. There was a trial done that after 4 weeks on tocotrienes that of 250 milligrams, it showed a decrease in the total cholesterol by 15%. It reduced the LDLs by 18% and the triglycerides by 14%. We also have another great protocol in our office for lowering cholesterol, and that was put out by the Cleveland Heart Institute. And it is a wonderful program that we can lower triglycerides and cholesterol in about 90 days by doing a really simple protocol. We want to, another source of vitamin D is your delta tocotrienes, and this is an enzyme that improves the fatty liver scores. So in people, we have fatty livers for lots of reasons, bad diet, alcohol consumption, but for whatever the reason, we can help lower that by taking the delta vitamin E. It will help decrease body mass. Of course, we can't just take a supplement alone. We need to take the dietary changes. Taking your vitamin E and eating your donut is not going to work. Know your supplements and why you're taking them. It's really critical to understand what are you taking, and when you read an article about a supplement, know what the resource was, who made the article, who wrote it, is it a company selling the supplement that wrote it, or is it an independent author, and is that somebody you can trust? And also, make sure that you're buying the right supplement when you're going out there, because you can buy something and it can be totally the wrong thing. Breast health, this is a really big topic. There is 1 in 8 chance that every woman could develop breast cancer. So there's very few of us that are going to avoid that issue. So we really, really need to be aware of breast health and keep ourselves healthy. We need to know about how to test ourselves. And I always tell women, they'll say to me, oh, I've been to the doctor and he checked me and I'm good. I'm like, that is one day in 365 days. Things grow pretty quickly with cancer. So just because last October 4th you didn't have breast cancer doesn't mean that, in December you won't. So I tell women to do regular breast exams. Other women will say, oh, I get my yearly mammogram. Again, that's one time a year somebody looked at your breast tissue. So if you do some real simple things, first off, remember your family history. Get details about it. These people won't be here forever to answer the questions. If somebody has cancer in your family, start writing down who it is, what kind they have, and who else had cancer. So you can answer these questions to your doctor and do a monthly breast exam. So women will say, I don't understand. I don't know how to do it. It's too complicated. It makes me fearful. I'm afraid of it. I have devised a very, very simple way for women to do a breast exam. You buy some index cards, you get 12 index cards. Top right-hand corner, you put today's date. That date should, the day you do your breast exam is ideally to do it at the end of your cycle. Reason being, you have less breast tenderness, it's easier to do then. And always do it around the same time of the month, every month, because the tissue will feel very similar. Hormones do change what the breast tissue may feel like. And then draw a circle on your paper. Put an R over the right one and an L over the left one. It indicates right breast, left breast. Draw that into 4 quadrants, and then you just start at the nipple and work around in circles and feel for anything that you find. Whatever you find, draw a little line out there and make an indication of what you found. It's the size of a nickel. It's the size of a dime. It feels like a pea, a lima bean. Make it something you can visually equate to. And then put that card aside. Next month, when it's time to do it again, do the same thing. And don't forget to check your underarms and up around the armpit area there. But what happens, the best time to do this is right after you've been to the gynecologist and you've got a clean bill of health, because that way you won't be stressing over it. But what happens if something changes from 1 month to the next month? That's an alarm system. That's when you call the doctor, you get in, you get a follow-up, and you say, hey, something's new. And take your little index cards along so you can say, yes, I have been doing this, and I know what normal feels like for me. Normal for you will be different than normal for somebody else. So it's very important to get to know your own breast tissue and your own health, and we can do that. And I always advocate that we teach young girls how to do this. And I'm saying girls because we have younger and younger women. There are quite a few women in their 20s now developing breast cancer. When these girls are old enough to learn about their menstrual cycle, they're old enough to learn about breast examination, and we need to start this earlier. So we need to remember not to be fearful and just to learn and educate ourselves about it and keep a log of it. We also have to remember that breast cancer has many factors associated with it. Genetics is one. We can't change genetics. Obesity is another. That is something we can definitely change. And diet is another, as well as nutrition and toxins we're exposed to. So ladies, be careful of what you clean with, what you breathe, where you work, what you inhale. If you're somewhere where you have to work around toxic chemicals, make sure you have the proper ventilation equipment to do so. And toxic chemicals include household cleaners, that all of these toxins love to stay in fat tissue. So when we're obese, that's where the toxins go. And also when we have a lot of fat tissue in the breast area, that's where they will hang out and stay. Drink lots of water. Flush the system. Alcohol has been linked to having some adverse effects on women's health. So when we're drinking more than 3 glasses of alcohol a week, we're probably consuming more than we should, and that could have adverse effects on your health. Exercise, we can change that. 5 times a week, 30 minutes a day is definitely something that will help you. Manage your BMI. I hear women come in and say all the time, oh, I just don't like those charts. Well, nobody likes the chart. Nobody likes the scale, but they are good guidelines, and we know that's where people should be. Unless you are super tall, you fit into that BMI scale. And it's pretty accurate. I'm not saying it's the gold standard, but you know, a few pounds above or below, you're probably safe. But when you are 20 or 30 pounds above BMI or below, you're in health issue problems. Supplementing with vitamin E, gamma-linoleic acid, and iodine, chaseberry, they also help for breast health. So those are a couple of supplements that are out there. The American Journal of Cancer Research did a study on 1,170 women with breast cancer, and they followed them for 87.4 months after they were diagnosed with breast cancer. And they found a supplement as simple as magnesium was found to be associated with the risk lowering of breast cancer, and it caused a lower risk of death. And magnesium is a very inexpensive supplement. It's available in many forms. When people are sick, I often advocate that they take it in a powder form because it's easily to digest. And it also is very beneficial in helping you sleep. So I say take a scoop or two and put it in some water, warm water, and drink it before you go to bed, and it helps you relax. It's good for muscles. So that is just a simple tidbit to have there. Omega-3 fatty acids are great antioxidants and the anti-inflammatory protective. We've talked about antioxidants many times. These are your fish oils. Science knows that inflammation plays a significant role in the growth of tumors. So if we have a really bad inflammatory diet, we have a disease that's considered inflammatory, and cancer is listed under those inflammatory diseases, as is diabetes and arthritis and all your gut and bowel disorders. We need to decrease that. And one of the benefits that taking the omega-3 fats, there are several of those. The main benefit is for breast health. But it also decreases the strength of the estrogen hormones. And many breast cancers are estrogen-driven, ladies. So take some omega-3 fish oil and make sure it's a really good one. What the omega-3s do is they quell the cancer-promoting the cancer-promoting factors of chronic inflammation that cause breast tumors, and they can also help shrink those breast tumors in size and prevent them from becoming metastasizing or spreading. So women with the highest amounts of omega-3 fatty acids have about a 500% less incidence of breast cancer and metastasism. So that's a pretty big number compared to women with low levels of this. In our office, we run a blood test that will tell you your omega-3 levels, and it breaks it down to all the essential fatty acids. So it's a very, very nice test. We typically use it for cardiac patients. We tend to use it for breast cancer survivors, and we're looking at using it as a preventative measure to help people decide, are they at risk for these types of things? So if this is a family history or something you want to do for risk prevention, it's a great test to do. And I always say in our office, you should test and not guess. Because if you're seeing somebody for your nutritional value and they're saying, well, I think you should take this, or maybe this is good for you. Yes, maybe it is, but maybe it's not. So test and don't guess and find out what you really need. We know that medical mushrooms are also used to help support women with breast cancer because of the beta-glucans in them. This is found in the maitake mushroom. They have great immune supports. Mushrooms have been used for thousands of years for helping with immune system and for helping boost your immune system. They increase the macrophages, which are part of your white blood cells. And they help. What that does is the white blood cells will go ahead and engulf and destroy cancer cells that are floating around, pick up microbes and other bad bugs and foreign cells. Beta-glucans then stimulate the signaling of these proteins in the immune system known as the interleukin 1 and interleukin 2. And this is part of your immune system. So if we can make that work better, we can slow down disease processes. Diet, we talk about food every show. Diet is a fundamental role in our health. One of the big things with breast cancer, we say avoid soy unless it's completely organic and no GMOs. Avoid isoflavones unless you've been directed to take them as a supplement, because sometimes they'll worsen estrogen-based cancers. Not always, but in some cases they can. And all phytoestrogen types of chemicals are out there. We use a lot of natural herbal things, and they have what they call phytoestrogens in. So if you have breast cancer, be very careful of what you're using herbally, because you may be feeding it. We can't have a show without talking about vitamin D. Vitamin D is one of these things that we talk about each show, and vitamin D is a very big component to helping control cancer. So one of the things I want to offer you today is to call our office and ask for a copy of our vitamin D protocol. Our number is 610-208-0404, and we'll mail it to you at no cost to you. And this is just a great piece of literature. It's not something I wrote. It's put out by the Institute of Functional Medicine, and they really show you what foods are high in vitamin D. And when you see the foods that are high in vitamin D and how much you have to eat, you'll start to supplement. And it also tells you to get tested, and then you can put your number on the scale and see how well you fare. Vitamin D is a powerhouse supplement. It's fat soluble, and it's an anti-inflammatory supplement as well. It's also anti-estrogenic. So being anti-estrogenic, it affects breast cell cancer. And 3/4 of the women with breast cancer are vitamin D deficient. And mainly we see an increased vitamin D levels is associated with your decrease of your risk for breast cancer diagnosis. So I tell most women in my office that vitamin D is a very inexpensive, simple way to prevent yourself from getting any type of cancer, not just breast cancer. So test your vitamin D, know your vitamin D levels, and just know that 30, when your doctor says 30 is good, 30 is the bottom level of normal for the vitamin D test. So please call the office at 610-208-0404 and ask for our vitamin D sheet, and you can just educate yourself a little bit more and maybe educate your physician on where do you want to be with your vitamin D for healthy levels under the hospice that the Functional Medicine Institutes puts out. And as always, we have more information to share than we have time, but we have a couple great things coming up this month, or next month, in November 1st through the 10th. We are going to be part of Berks County Best Kept Secret. So if you've never been on the Best Kept Secret tour, stop at our office, pick up a ticket. The tickets are $10. Some of the proceeds will go to a local nonprofit organization in the county. And it's a great venture for family and friends and ladies to get together and go out and find some really great little niche stores in Berks County. It's a 10-day program. And there's lots of coupons. You get your money back in gifts and coupons and food and all kinds of fun things. And we have some wonderful giveaways we're going to give away at our office that week. And we still have some honey left. We've sold about half of our honey, which is all organic, natural honey, no GMOs, no pesticides. And my son has the hives, and he's been raising the bees. And we have had some great success with selling the honey in the store. So if you're looking for something to help you with the allergies and local bees, we have it at the store. You can stop in and pick that up. Also, I just would like to offer you to stop in if you have any questions on your health or any needs. And what we do is we start out with a consultation, a history, examination, and then we share with you what testing might be beneficial for you. And this is all individual, customized healthcare plans. So if you're looking for something besides a cookie cutter, give me a call at 610-208-0404. And don't forget to ask for your vitamin D form. We'll send you that paperwork out right away. There's no cost to that. All you need to do is give us a name and an email, and we'll fax it to you. I mean, we'll email it to you. And if you don't have an email, we'll mail it to you. So till next month, enjoy and take care of your health and have a safe fall.
Nutrition and Wellness on BCTV is underwritten by Kulp Chiropractic Nutrition and Wellness Center.